Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy. Brett Summers. Nipsey Russell. Marianne Mobley. Richard Dawson. And Ann Elder. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
Yes, sirree. Thank you. All right. Thank you very much. We have a very enthusiastic bunch here in the studio, and we hope you at home are equally enthusiastic about our endeavors here. And
They're not enthusiastic, they're drunk.
No. Are you ready?
Yes, we are ready.
Is there anything? Is something going on here? Are you two an item?
Hold up, little car. Right?
Oh, yes.
Well, these two, they don't have a brain between them.
They held up.
She pulled him out of the air, looked over, and so I wrote, Achoo. Yeah. She put Bless You there, right?
Yeah, and we wrote.
They
wrote.
Held it up.
Achoo. Oh,
and I wrote, Stop Sneezing.
They'll never forgive us.
He wrote, Stop Sneezing. I think he'd have. You're all ding-a-lings.
All
right. Let's welcome Joyce Nunley and Loretta Savory. Loretta's our current champion. She's won $600 in one game. Are you all right? You're going to be okay?
Yes.
Okay, she said a word. She's all right. Joyce Nunley is challenging her. We started round one last time we were together, and she scored four times. She matched four of our celebrities. So now we're going to complete round one after we have this message. All right, here we go. I'll push this button. Thing goes down. See how everything works like magic here. And you know that you have got your work cut out for you.
Right.
All right. Here we go. The salesman yelled, Hey, Noah! With all the animals you got up there on that ark, I'll bet you could use a blank. Salesman, he's down in the in a rope, and he's a salesman. He's rowing the boat. And he's passing this big boat.
Wait, spell sail.
It's called Ark, and the captain is a guy named Noah. You see, and he yells, "Hey Noah, with all the animals you got up there on that ark, I'll bet you could use a blank." They've already finished writing. And you're still thinking about it.
Well, I could have finished. I was just fascinated.
Oh, I see. Thank you. You think about it.
Can I throw mine away?
No.
It's
in there. Like you're
lucky. We want to see your first effort. Trust your first instinct. That's your best. Ready, go. Hold everything now. Loretta will give us her answer to this. Hey, Noah, with all the animals you got up there on that ark, I'll bet you could use a...
Shovel.
Of that too. You've been thinking about that all the time. The shovel there, right? I didn't think of that. I wish I'd thought of it there. Did you think of that, Bert?
He said, yes, of course I thought of that, but you could
use
a shovel.
Oh, there it is, a shovel.
Knee deep
there. Once or another. Shovel is her answer, Brett. What is yours?
Listen, I said shovel in essence. It's just that I wasn't raised in the country and I live in California and there's no snow. So I said big cloth.
A big cloth. Oh,
that's not a match.
Big cloth is not a match.
I couldn't think of
big cloth.
You know, you get to wipe her arms and everything.
Oh, it's all right. Just throw it away. Let's forget it.
That's a Marianne Mobley answer.
I refuse to answer on the grounds that it would incriminate me.
Air refresher. Oh. This is air refresher. Okay, so far you got one match, Loretta, and let's go to this lady.
Well,
yes.
All of us practical ones know that you need a shovel.
A shovel.
And a big cloth. Right, Loretta?
All right, so that's two for you, Loretta. What about you, sir?
You're doing better.
Yeah.
Well, you see, you only need a shovel if they are
not... Is this going to be long?
Why, where the hell are you going to go?
To a landing.
Just like that, I believe you. No, the only reason you would need that if the animals weren't trained.
Oh.
you train them, so obviously you would need a sandbox.
A sandbox.
Now, a big one.
Oh, I say.
And a big cloth.
Yes. I like big cloth better.
A sandbarge.
All right, to go.
And, yeah. That reminds me of something.
Oh, great. Shovel is her answer. What's yours?
Yeah, I said a kitty box.
A kitty box. Yeah, a big one. Okay. So that was two for you, and now we go to round two. At the end of round one, scores 4-2 in favor of our challenger. And Joyce, would you make a selection, if you please?
Yes, I'll take A, please.
She says A.
Do I write?
Last time around, you matched four of our celebrities. Now you'll be trying to match the other two, Bert and Richard. You are the only two who will participate.
Draw attention.
On his way home from Europe, Steve stopped in Denmark to change blank. On his way home from Europe, Steve stopped in Denmark to change blank. All right, the two gentlemen are ready, Joyce, so we'll get your response now. On his way home from Europe, Steve stopped in Denmark to change...
his sex.
His sex, she said. Little operation there. All right, here's... Bert Convy, who will give us his response now.
Well, I don't understand this really, but the answer means he changed his sex.
Sex. Changed sex. So there's one for you. And now you got one more to go.
Changes. Well, I've already been, but thank you anyway.
Oh, all right.
As a matter of fact, he did change his sex. He changed it for a gas dryer.
His sex.
Okay. So you got all the way across the board there, six. Now, you must match everybody remaining to stay in the game. That is four celebrities, Brett, Nipsey, Richard, and Anne. And you four are the only ones who will participate in this. The old lady who lived in a shoe said, "Now that all the kids are gone, I think I'll move into a blank." It's the old lady who lived in a shoe. She said, "Now that all the kids are gone, I think I'll move into a blank."
Bert Convy is distracting me by singing. Move into an... Okay.
Okay. All right. Ready, Ann?
Yep.
Think carefully, Loretta. What answer do you think might match the four celebrities? Now that all the kids are gone, I think I'll move into a...
sandal.
Into a sandal.
I went blank. I really...
Well, it's a sandal is smaller than a shoe, isn't it? So there's some logic to that answer, isn't it? Must match all four of them. One miss and it's all over. All right,
Brett. You move into a sandal, honey, it'll rain all over you.
It will.
You have to move into an apt... an apartment.
An apartment. So our winner now is Joyce Nunley. Congratulations. Can you come along, please? That's $100 for you.
Same idea.
Good. Slipper, that's what you had? An apartment. Okay. Loretta, we've got $600 to you for together with our thanks for being on Match Game 73. It's been a pleasure meeting you. I hope you enjoyed it.
Had a lot of fun. Thank
you. Bye, Loretta Savory. Now, you see, you're going to have a go at the big money super match here, and you catch your breath for a moment. We'll pass along these messages, and then we'll get back to this.
All right.
Joyce Nunley is our new champion. She just won a game. She's got $100, and now she's going to try for $5,000 in the super match. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. You look calm and cool and collected, and I'm very happy about that. You know, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank news, or blank news, whatever accent you want to put on it. The answer they gave most often is worth $500, Joyce, if you can match it. Second most frequent response, $250, and the third, $100. Three celebrities are allowed to give you a little help. Choose them one at a time, get their responses.
Marianne, please. There's some good ones to this, but how about good news?
Good news, that's one. Good news is one. Number two.
Bert.
How about the reverse, bad news?
How about it? Okay,
about
we got good news. I got good news and I got bad news for you. All right, one more.
Richard, please.
I love you, Joyce. The eyewitness news. That will give... That will give CBS little heart palpitations.
Really?
Because they're on ABC.
I know you. You had to say it all, huh?
Of course I did. We must be honest.
All right. Eyewitness News is his answer.
Please forgive me.
You may choose among those three, bad news, good news, eyewitness news, or give us one of your own. But right now, Joyce, we need an answer from you.
Okay, I will go with good news.
Good news. It's better than bad news.
And it's better than eyewitness.
It's better than eyewitness. Good news is her answer. Let's find out if it's up there, and if it is there, where it is. First, the $100 response. 6 o'clock
news.
Wasn't
so far. Did I lie right? to you? Eight. Yeah.
Is that the
thing? Of course. None of your rubbish.
No, they're all on 6 o'clock.
Oh, that's not nothing to do with me.
All right. Looking for good news. May we see the $250 response? Bad news.
Good news.
I hope so too for your sake. Looking for good news. Here it is. Last chance, Joyce. The $500 response.
Good news.
Good for you. Okay. That means the $500 is yours, and it also means you're going to be playing for 10 times that amount now. I almost said 500 times that amount. Boy, that would be a lot of money. 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now, to collect the money, you've got to match one celebrity, only one, and it must be an exact match. So please choose one now.
Bert, please.
All right, Bert, you get ready to write. Joyce, you face me. Here is the question worth $5,000. Give us your response to this in writing, if you please, Bert. Good for blank. Good for blank. Bert is finally finished, and now, Joyce, we call for your response to this. Good for...
nothing.
Good for nothing. Well, there was no doubt in their minds at all, the studio audience, about that answer. I don't know about his. Right now, Bert, for $5,000, we must see your answer.
Yes, I wish the audience could write it. I said good for you.
Good for you.
No good for you.
Joyce. All right. So, you're up to $600, Joyce. You're the champ. You're going to play another game. You may be back here again. Let's meet your new player. Here comes Johanna Sartori.
Hello, Johanna.
And it stops. There you go. You ladies know each other? Indeed you do. We welcome you, Johanna.
Thank you.
And we ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself.
I'm a part-time waitress, and I'm a psychology major at Mount San Antonio College.
In where?
Mount San Antonio College.
Mount San Antonio. Is that? I'm not.
That's familiar. In Walnut.
Okay. Good luck to you here. You know how to play?
Yeah.
Shall we begin?
Uh-huh.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Good. See what happens when I push that button? It reveals two things there, and it's entirely up to you as to which question you want.
B, please.
B is what she wants. New game. Everybody plays. Count Dracula said, he said...
What did he say?
He said...
Good, you can tell us.
All right, I'll tell you. I've given up biting girls' necks. Now I bite blanks.
You gotta be kidding. He didn't say that.
He said that.
What did he say again?
He said...
Just like down clam bake, honey.
He said, I have given up biting girls next. Now I bite blanks.
You couldn't help you.
Wait a minute.
Make one answer on the card. We're waiting for you, Marianne. Everyone else is finished but Marianne.
Oh, shoot.
They'll be playing the anthem, darling, if you don't hurry up. It'll all be over.
Okay. Everybody's ready over there now? Johanna, we call on you for your response. I've given up biting girls' necks. Now I bite blanks.
Arms.
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 Wait, don't get hostile.
That's right.
It's better than clam bake.
Every man to his own
taste.
That's
right. Bert, what do you say the count was fighting?
The count has given up girls for men.
What?
And now I bite men.
As Countess Dracula.
I see. All right. Brett, what do you say?
What was this cat's name?
Dracula. Count Dracula.
Count Dracula started biting boys because he didn't like them.
Oh, I see. Okay, no match there. Nipsey.
Well, I was completely out of whack because I thought he was making news and bit dogs.
Okay. To each his own.
Now, see, every one of you should feel very ashamed for hustling me along because... Wait, let me... For rushing me along because... Yes.
No one was trying to hustle you. Don't change the script.
No one was trying to hustle you at all.
Well, in all fairness, I was.
Oh, you were.
In all fairness, I was.
I've been trying all week.
Oh, all right.
He'll do anything to go to a clam bake.
Can we have the response here?
Listen, because I said arms,
oh,
too.
Oh, this is a mess. Yeah. Okay.
Excuse me, I'm trying to get...
What do you say, Hustler?
What do you think?
Well, he gave up biting the girls, so he now bites the boy.
I see.
Ba-boom.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right. Ba-boom. Now, Ann Elder.
Yes.
Good for nothing. Back to that.
He went from one place to the bottom. He went to the feet.
To the feet.
What a nice thought.
So you matched one celebrity there, Johanna, and we'll come to your half of the round after we do these messages. Johanna scored one match in her end of round one. Now let's see how Joyce does with her end of round one. Henry said, Doc, I keep having this dream that my wife turns into a blank. Henry said that.
Who said that, honey?
Henry said, Doc, I keep having this dream that my wife turns into a blank.
You little devil, you.
Rascal there. Henry's a rascal. All right. You ready down here? You ready up there, gentlemen?
No.
The lady's ready.
I'm ready for this old lightning.
I'm ready.
Okay. Now, Joyce. Henry said, Doc, I keep having this dream that my wife turns into a...
man.
Oh, really?
Man.
She said man. Man is her answer. Bert,
that's
what's
a
your
nightmare.
Answer?
She says man. I said animal, which is
animal.
Kind
which
of
is
like
a form
man.
Of man.
A form of man. It's a homo sapien, I believe, isn't
wishful
it?
Wishful thinking.
That was Count Dracula's question. What do you say, Brett?
Well, darling, I thought of all the things that Jack calls me, and then I cleaned it up, and I said dog.
Into a dog. Yeah. My wife keeps turning into a dog. Nipsey, what did you say?
They say the best way to stop a girl from making love is to marry her. So I thought his wife turned into a lover.
Oh, that's a sweet thought. A very sweet thought.
Vicious. Go back to Jack.
Now, here is Miss Sweetness. What do you say?
Double, double, toil and trouble. She turned into a witch.
A witch.
That's what she did.
You can't spell either.
There's her answer. Still looking
well,
for a
I can't
man
talk,
here.
So why...
What do you say, Richard?
Oh, I haven't seen a man all night, officer. It's been very quiet. But I did see a pumpkin.
A pumpkin. Walking down the street.
What turned into a pumpkin owning?
Okay. Here's the only sane one in the whole bunch.
It's because I'm also looking for a man.
Good girl. Yeah.
So at the end of round one, the score is tied 1-1. Let's go to round two. And here we go. Johanna, make a selection.
I'll stay with B.
B is what she wants. And everyone except Marianne participates. The 102-year-old man said, I haven't had a blank in 83 years. That's what he said. He was 102, could hardly talk. 102-year-old man said, I haven't had a blank in 83 years. Ready? Okay. Johanna, it's up to you now. The 102-year-old man said, I haven't had a blank in 83 years.
Drink.
A drink.
Yeah.
She says a drink. What do you say, Bert?
I say he hasn't had a drink.
Oh, a drink. Scores for her. Brett?
Hope it never happens to me.
Okay, you're on
the
right
track.
I don't
know why it was staggering, but he hadn't had
a... Okay. What do you say there?
Actually, he was with a lady, and he said, I haven't had an affair
in 83 years.
You hamburger, you're having one.
Oh, I see. Who would want a 102-year-old man?
Anyway.
103-year-old woman. I was waiting for you.
Can you bring a halt to this insanity and show
yes,
us your answer?
I think he would have had an affair had he had a drink.
That's it. Okay. We don't have time to finish this round, do we? Oh, all right. Okay. So it's 5-1 at this moment. We've got these messages for you, and then you come back, and we'll tell you what happens next. The score here is 5-1. It's the middle of round two, our final round. Our challenger is ahead. You're going to have an opportunity to catch up. You must match four celebrities to stay in the running next time we meet. And we'll look forward to seeing you, both of you ladies, then. And we'll look forward to seeing all of you. Is there anyone who has a final word of wisdom he'd like to add? He or she, would you? You seem a little depressed. Is everything all right?
Well, my cat at home.
Yes.
Drank some gasoline.
Oh.
Ran around, went up a tree and fell down, just stiff.
Was it dead?
No, just out of gas.
Oh, I see. Gene Rayburn saying so long for Match Game 73. Join us next time.
Today's consolation prizes are Clairol's four-way lighted mirror, so you can make up in the lights you'll be singing. Clairol's four-way lighted mirror and Clairol's three-way hair setter gives your curl more choices, water mist, conditioning mist, or regular sets. Clairol's three-way hair setter. And an assortment of party time cocktail mixes. The mixes that have both quality and variety now make a perfect drink every time. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Tubman production. Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy. Brett Summers. Nipsey Russell. Marianne Mobley. Richard Dawson. And Ann Elder. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
Yes, sirree. Thank you. All right. Thank you very much. We have a very enthusiastic bunch here in the studio, and we hope you at home are equally enthusiastic about our endeavors here. And
they're not enthusiastic, they're drunk.
No. Are you ready?
Yes, we are ready.
Is there anything? What now? What is something going on here? Are you two an item?
Hold up, little car. Right?
Oh, yes.
Well, these two—they don't have a brain between them.
They held up.
She pulled me out of the air, looked over, and so I wrote, "Ah, Choo." Yeah. She put "Bless you" there, right?
Yeah. And we wrote.
We wrote. They held it up.
Ah, Choo. Oh,
and I wrote, "Stop sneezing."
He'll never forgive us.
He wrote, "Stop sneezing." I think he'd have. You're all ding-a-lings.
All
right. Let's welcome Joyce Nunley and Loretta Savory. Loretta's our current champion. She's won $600 in one game. Are you all right? You're going to be okay?
Yes.
Okay, she said a word. She's all right. Joyce Nunley is challenging her. We started round one last time we were together, and she scored four times. She matched four of our celebrities. So now we're going to complete round one after we have this message.
For an apt, an apartment.
An apartment. So our winner now is Joyce Nunley. Congratulations. Can you come around, please? That's $100
for you.
Good. Slipper, that's what you had? An apartment, okay. Loretta, we've got $600 to you for together with our thanks for being on Match Game 73. It's been a pleasure meeting you. I hope you enjoyed it.
Had a lot of fun. Thank you.
Bye, Loretta Savory. Now you see you're going to have a go at the big money super match here, and you catch your breath for a moment. We'll pass along these messages, and then we'll get back to this.
right.
Joyce Nunley is our new champion. She just won a game. She's got $100, and now she's going to try for $5,000 in the super match. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. You look calm and cool and collected, and I'm very happy about that. You know, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank news. Blank news or blank news, whatever accent you want to put on it. The answer they gave most often is worth $500, Joyce, if you can match it. Second most frequent response, $250, and the third, $100. Three celebrities are allowed to give you a little help. Choose them one at a time, get their responses.
Marianne, please.
There's some good ones to this, but how about good news?
Good news! That's one. Good news is one. Number two.
Bert.
How about the reverse, bad news?
How about it? Okay, we got good news. I got good news and I got bad news for you. All right, one more.
Richard, please.
I love you, Joyce. The eyewitness news. That will give CBS a little heart palpitations.
Really?
Because they're on ABC.
I know. You had to say it all, huh?
Of course I did. We must be honest.
All right, eyewitness news. All right, here we go.
Uh-huh.
I'll push this button. Thing goes down. See how everything works like magic here. And you know that you have got your work cut out for you.
Right.
All right.
Sure.
Here we go. The salesman yelled, Hey, Noah! With all the animals you got up there on that ark, I'll bet you could use a blank. Salesman, he's down in the in a rope, and he's a salesman. He's rowing the boat, and he's passing this big boat.
Wait, spell sail.
It's called Ark, and the captain is a guy named Noah. You see, and he yells, "Hey Noah, with all the animals you got up there on that ark, I'll bet you could use a blank." They've already finished writing. You're still thinking about it.
Well, I could have finished. I was just fascinated.
Oh, I see. Thank you. You think about it.
Can I throw mine away?
No.
It's in there.
Well, we want to see your first effort. Trust your first instinct. That's your best. Ready, go. Hold everything now. Loretta will give us her answer to this. Hey, Noah, with all the animals you got up there on that ark, I'll bet you could use a...
shovel.
That too. You've been thinking about that all the time. The shovel there, right? I didn't think of that. I wish I'd thought of it there. Did you think of that, Bert?
He said, yes, of course I thought of that, but you could
use
a shovel.
Oh, there it is, a shovel.
Knee deep.
Oh, once there, Loretta. Shovel is her answer, Brett. What is yours?
Listen, I said shovel in essence. It's just that I wasn't raised in the country and I live in California and there's no snow. So I said big cloth.
A big cloth.
That's not a match.
Big cloth is not a match.
I couldn't think of
shovel.
Big cloth. You know, you get to wipe your arms and everything.
Oh, it's all right. Just throw it away. Let's forget it.
That's a Marianne Mobley answer.
I refuse to answer on the grounds that it would incriminate me.
Air refresher. This is air refresher. Okay, so far you got one match, Loretta, and let's go to this lady.
Well,
yes.
All of us practical ones know that you need a shovel.
A shovel.
And a big claw. Right, Loretta?
All right, so it's two for you, Loretta. What about you, sir?
You're doing better.
Yeah.
Well, you see, you only need a shovel if they are
not... Is this going to be long?
Why, where the hell are you going to go?
To a landing.
Dressed like that, I believe you. No, the only reason you would need that, if the animals weren't trained.
Oh.
You train them, so obviously you would need a sandbox.
A sandbox.
So a big one.
Oh, I say.
And a big cloth.
Yes.
I like big cloth better.
A sandbarge.
All right.
To go.
Yeah. That reminds me of something.
Oh, shovel is her answer. What's yours?
Yeah, I said a kitty box.
A kitty box. Yeah, a big one. Okay. That was two for you, and now we go to round two. At the end of round one, scores 4-2 in favor of our challenger. And Joyce, would you make a selection, if you please?
Yes, I'll take A, please.
She says A.
Am I right?
Last time around, you matched four of our celebrities. Now you'll be trying to match the other two, Bert and Richard. You are the only two who will participate.
draw attention.
On his way home from Europe, Steve stopped in Denmark to change blank. On his way home from Europe, Steve stopped in Denmark to change blank. All right, the two gentlemen are ready. Joyce, so we'll get your response now. On his way home from Europe, Steve stopped in Denmark to change...
his sex.
His sex, she said. Little operation there. All right, here's Bert Convy, who will give us his response now.
We hope. I don't understand this really, but the answer means he changed his sex.
Sex. Changed sex. So there's one for you. And now you got one more to go.
Changes. Well, I've already been, but thank you anyway.
Oh, all right.
As a matter of fact, he did change his sex. He changed it for a gas dryer.
His sex.
Okay. So you got all the way across the board there. Six. What did you say? Now you must match everybody remaining to stay in the game. That is four celebrities: Brett, Nipsey, Richard, and Anne. And you four are the only ones who will participate in this. The old lady who lived in a shoe said, "Now that all the kids are gone, I think I'll move into a blank." It's the old lady who lived in a shoe. She said, "Now that all the kids are gone, I think I'll move into a blank."
Bert Convy is distracting me by singing. Move into an... okay.
Okay. All right. Ready, Ann?
Yep.
Think carefully, Loretta. What answer you think might match the four celebrities? Now that all the kids are gone, I think I'll move into a...
sandal.
Into a sandal.
I went blank. I really...
Well, it's a sandal is smaller than a shoe, isn't it? So there's some logic to that answer, isn't it? Cute. Must match all four of them. One miss and it's all over. All right,
Brett. You move into a sandal, honey, it'll rain all over you.
It will.
You have to move into...